It's the final visit to Quebec for the NASCAR Pinty Series in 2016. Teams have returned to La Belle Province to fight for every championship point at the Autodrome Saint-Eustache.
Saint-Eustache, just north of Montreal, as we bring you the Lucas Oil 250 presented by Bumper to Bumper and Coors Light. Hello, everyone, and welcome to race number 11 of the NASCAR Pinty Series. I'm Dave Bradley, along with Adam Ross and veteran pit reporter Todd Lewis. This is our fourth visit to Quebec. We only have two races left in the championship.
Dave, this 4/10 mile oval here in Saint-Eustache is a NASCAR home track owned by the LaBrosse family. It's been packed all day. The fans in Quebec love their NASCAR.
Almost half the field here tonight are from La Belle Province, and there is a good look at 16-year-old Cayden Lapcevich, your current NASCAR Pinty Series points leader, as he climbs into a 76 Fastline Motorsport Dodge entry.
Lapcevich has a 30-point lead over Andrew Ranger, but the battle behind them is really tight for third place.
Well, that's between Lacroix, Dumoulin, and Tagliani, and with more on how they'll line up for today's race, let's send it down to Todd.
That's right, guys. Qualifying laps were rained out as a shower passed through. So according to the NASCAR rule book, the grid is set by times during the first practice session. That means the 32 of Alex LaBey has the E3 Sparkplugs pole award. He was on the pole in 2014. He'd like to have his second victory of the season tonight. Alongside on row number one, the 74 of Kevin Lacroix, two-time winner already this season, but still looking for his first oval track victory in the series. It could come here tonight. In row number two, a couple of hard-charging veterans. The 17 of DJ Kennington, a winner at Saint-Eustache in 2010. He's been fast all day. And on the outside of row number two, it's the 27 of Andrew Ranger. Again, a two-time winner already this season. He sits second in the championship points. He was a winner at this track last year. A win tonight could keep his championship hopes alive. Let's go back up the track and get the proceeding started.
Gentlemen, start your engines.
Ramallah from Lucas Oil, Global Vice President of Sales, here to give the command, Dave.
All the engines fire here on the front straightaway as the window nets are up. The crews have left the front chute. Now you see the dignitaries making their way to the stands. We'll have a number of onboard views, including from the 59 of Gary Clute. Anthony Simone back in the field here today.
They weren't sure if they were going to make this trip. Great to see the 95 car here. Jason Hathaway, always a favorite on the oval tracks.
And DJ Kennington, another driver, very strong here at Saint-Eustache. As the field starts to roll, we'll take a look at tonight's E3 Sparkplug starting lineup on pole. As you heard Todd mention, Alex LaBey in the 32, Kevin Lacroix in the 74.
DJ Kennington on row number two on the inside alongside Andrew Ranger in the 27. Row number three, Cayden Lapcevich, our points leader on the inside. And there's the 95, Anthony Simone.
Looking back to row number four, that's where we find Jason Hathaway, J.F. Dumoulin in the 04, making a rare oval start. Row number five has Simone Zielvien in the number 25 and Gary Clute in the 59.
To row number six, Alex Tagliani deep in the field alongside Adam Martin in the number nine. Row number seven, veteran Mark Dilley in the 02 will start alongside the 47 of LP Dumoulin. And rounding out the field from Oakville, Ontario, it's Larry Jackson in the number one.
So the field making their warm-up laps. You'll see them weave side to side as they try to build some heat in these Goodyear Eagles. There you see a good look at the 04 of J.F. Dumoulin making his first oval start of the year, as we mentioned, and a couple hundred Spectra Premium employees on hand. They've occupied the stands at turn one to cheer on their driver.
With the E3 Sparkplugs race analysis, we're going to go 250 laps tonight. But, Dave, the big story is the weather. We have been dodging raindrops all day long. It could be a race to halfway.
Let's head down pit side and check in with Todd with tonight's Leland lead up to the green.
A couple things we're watching for just before we go green. The 25 CBR team machine this weekend, piloted by Simone Dion-Vienne. It's his first oval start. Told me earlier he's very happy with how the car is set up. He's taking this as a learning experience and hoping to do more ovals in the future. Also watch for the 18, starting 11. Tyler Case, the crew chief, and Alex Tagliani, the driver, struggled during practice. They've made some changes, didn't get a chance to test them out during qualifying. They said if they're not very good early on, look for them to dive in and make some changes.
And there you can see the one to go before we take the green flag here in the Lucas Oil 250 in Saint-Eustache, Quebec. Good luck at the Best Buy sponsor, number 25, as Todd mentioned, Simon Zionvien. But the front of the field starting to bunch up. Set on practice time, so there's a little bit of a wild card in here. You don't know who has the proper setup for tonight's race. We're about to find out in through three and four for the final time. Getting set for the green flag, LeBay and Lacroix. Charol with the green flag, and we're underway.
Down into turn number one, trouble already. Dionvien around, Jason Hathaway around. About half a dozen cars involved in this one.
You saw the damage to the 18 of Alex Tagliani as well, and we are still under green as every car able to pull away. A drag race down the front stretch for the top spot. It looks like Lacroix is going to lead lap number one.
The top six all in a tight bunch, and everyone behind them is a full straightaway behind after that accident.
Boy, did you see the points leader, Cayden Lapcevich, get all kinds of crossways off of turn two.
Yellow flag will fly, reports of debris on the racetrack. That is no surprise, Dave.
No, and that puts an end to that great fight at the front of the field. Dionvien was one of the vehicles involved. Have another look.
It looked like he just didn't get wowed up down into turn one. Yeah, it gets right underneath Hathaway, and the track blocks up in a hurry.
It could be a rookie mistake. I mean, first time on an oval, but have a look. You see the fender flying from the 18 EpiPen Chevy, and there it goes.
That was a good view.
That was a good view.
As far as speed goes, that won't affect Alex Tagliani, but not having that fender to nudge people in front of you could be a problem.
Hathaway, the first to find his pit stall. The crew goes to work underneath and taunts in the 18 pit.
Lots of visible body damage to the right front of that 18 machine. The crew is over the wall with reciprocating saws, tape, bare bond, bungee cords, anything they can get their hands on to try to secure that body work. Alex Tagliani sits and waits for them to finish their work.
Fiberglass being peeled off the three. Kevin Lacroix is your early race leader. This NASCAR on TSN telecast from Autodrome Saint-Eustache is brought to you by Mopar, authentic performance, and by E3 Spark Plugs, born to burn. Getting set for the first restart, Kevin Lacroix controls the field here on lap six of the Lucas Oil 250. The fireworks started early, but here we go again. Green flag up in the air.
And you could see Lacroix was hesitant down into one. Here goes Ranger three wide to the inside.
Will this stick going into turn number three? Ranger's going to have second. LeBay fell back to third. No, he's still on the outside there.
And this is trial by fire for Kevin Lacroix, who is a gifted road racer, still developing his skills on the oval tracks. He looks pretty good so far tonight.
But that's the thing we learned when the driver of the Mopar Dodge was a young rookie in the then NASCAR Canadian Tire Series. When he came into this style of racing, he was an accomplished road racer, but it didn't take long for him to come up to speed. A racer is a racer, whether you're turning left or whether you're turning right and left.
At the time, what Andrew Ranger had was Dave Jacobs preparing cars and Billy Burns as a crew chief. What Kevin Lacroix has right now is Don Thompson Jr. preparing cars and serving as a crew chief. It's a common bond having that experience and guidance to speed track their learning curve.
And for Kevin Lacroix, he lives just down the street here in Saint-Eustache, Quebec. A battle for third, though. DJ Kennington, the Castrol-Edge Dodge, will sneak underneath the number 27 of Andrew Ranger. Look at the 95 of Anthony Simone. A little contact on the back bumper.
They were not going to come to this race as of last Sunday after Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. They weren't planning to come to this event. I don't know what changed their mind, but he's looking pretty good so far.
Cayden Lapcevich in the 76, your points leader, as we've mentioned time and time again. A significant cushion on the 27 of Andrew Ranger. Really, all he has to do is do exactly that. Keep that 27 into sight.
We had a great look at two changes they made here at the racetrack. The line Cayden Lapcevich is running, you couldn't run that last year. They moved turn one, the white line on the inside of the track, in about 10 feet. And right here where they come off of turn four, they've cut that concrete wall back by about 40 feet.
Hello, sir.
There you can see all the damage to the EpiPen number 18 of Alex Tagliani. And here's Lapcevich still working underneath the 95 of Anthony Simone.
This is similar to what he's done all year long. He races very hard, but he does as much as he can to stay off the cars around him.
Battle for fifth spot on the racetrack, and give the nod to the youngster in the 76, Cayden Lapcevich, as he clears the 95 off of turn four.
Simone able to get back down in line before Mark Dilley made a move to the inside. Saint-Eustache is a racetrack where you don't want to get hung up in the outside groove.
Now look at these two, the 59 of Gary Clute and the 02 of Mark Dilley. You only have to remember one race ago, or I should say on the last oval stop, these two have had some fireworks in the past. Dilley right on the back bumper of the NASCAR Next driver, Clute.
And here's Jason Hathaway in the Chaco number three, trying to come back through the field after his lap one skirmish. He's looking to get back into the top 10, battling with the Pelote number one of Larry Jackson.
And Jackson has run 10 races in 2016. He sits 10th in points. He's the most consistent driver in that CBRT stable.
You know, and that's what CBRT really needs, some consistent finishes, end the season on a positive note, which is the way they started it, with Robin Buck and Larry Jackson having back-to-back podium results.
Interesting note for the 32 of LeBay. He's got a new crew chief with him here today with some K&N series background. Clinton Cram has joined the team, and Alex himself will join some K&N races and some Xfinity races next season. He wants to build up his resume so he can get his NASCAR license for some of the bigger tracks and further his career.
I know the people behind Alex LeBay are very impressed with the poise he has behind the wheel. He's definitely on his way up.
Still this battle for 10th, give it to the three of Jason Hathaway as he clears the number one of Larry Jackson. So that Rebestis Brakes Chevrolet of Jason Hathaway sure doesn't look pretty, but it seems to be working pretty well.
Aerodynamics does not play a role in your performance here at Saint-Eustache. As we talked about earlier, the biggest thing you want as the race winds down is the ability to use that front bumper to just nudge the car in front of you and build yourself a line.
The old chrome horn, as they used to call it back when there were chrome bumpers on these stock cars. But you can see the 74 of Kevin Lacroix now coming under some pressure. The 32 of Alex LeBay, who won at Autodrome Chaudière, now pokes the nose to the inside.
Alex LeBay has as many laps here at Saint-Eustache as anybody, with the exception of the car running third, that Castrol Edge number 17. DJ Kennington probably has the most laps of anybody.
Board, Kevin Lacroix, the bumper-to-bumper Total Lubricants, number 74, sitting in second.
And doing a great job. Alex LeBay got by him. He didn't let him have the spot, but he didn't fight hard, drop back in line. Here we see a battle for fourth.
And it's a battle for your points championship as well. The 76 of Cayden Lapcevich coming into this one as your leader. Ranger needs to finish ahead of him if he wants any hope of battling back in these final two races.
And Dave, not only that, but Ranger needs to get up and win races. Cayden Lapcevich with a 30-point advantage right now. Ranger needs those three bonus points for winning. He can control that part, and then he has to hope that Cayden has some problems.
Historically, though, if you look at both of them, Ranger has a win here at Autodrome Saint-Eustache. Cayden Lapcevich has never been here.
No, and he wasn't sure what to make of this racetrack as we see the battle for seventh place. Gary Clute overtakes Anthony Simone in the 95. This racetrack is unlike almost any oval track you'll ever see. Flat as a pancake, the transition off of turn four onto the drag strip. A little bit of contact there with Simone and Clute, but the transition off of turn number four, where you come off the corner and then through the rubber laid down by the drag strip, it's a very awkward feel.
Give second spot to the number 17 Castrol Edge Dodge of DJ Kennington as he gets underneath the 74 of Kevin Lacroix.
This is as good as we've seen DJ Kennington run. He had podium results going in a couple of oval races, ran out of fuel in one of them, had a fuel pump go bad in another one. He's looking pretty good here tonight, and he does like this racetrack.
And generally, DJ Kennington's bad luck has really bitten him late in races. We saw it in Edmonton earlier on this year. So if DJ Kennington can sort of stay at the front, we'll keep an eye on him for those last few laps if he's still there.
And the big thing tonight is we look at a battle on the racetrack. LP Dumoulin in the 47, Gary Clute in the 59, racing for seventh. The big story tonight, we don't know when the last few laps of this race are going to be. Is it going to maybe a lap 125 when we get to the halfway and the race is official if the rain comes? Or is it going to be the lap 250, which is the scheduled distance?
Everybody playing amateur weathermen in the pits here tonight. They're watching the skies, watching radar on their phone, and trying to figure out when the rain will hit, if it'll even hit at all. But you see a couple beat-up race cars already in Jason Hathaway and Alex Tagliani.
And for the race fans who might not be familiar, in car racing, for a race to be official, for the results to count, for the points to be awarded and the money to be paid out, you have to make it to the halfway point of the race. So at that point, if weather does become a factor and they have to cancel, it is official. If the race ends right now, it has to be rescheduled to some point, whether it's tomorrow or another time. They have to get at least half of the scheduled distance in.
WeatherTech.ca, number 47 of LP Dumoulin, just ahead of the Ray Vestas brakes, number 3 of Jason Hathaway, and the EpiPen, number 18 of Alex Tagliani. That's what's great about Autodrome Saint-Eustache. I was going to say we have nose to tail running, and there is some contact there as Hathaway goes around. Caution is going away for the second time.
Yellow flag is out, and Hathaway takes the path of least resistance, which will send him down pit road. And the front end that they had taped together will need to be taped again. You see here, down into number 3, Hathaway about half a lane off the bottom, and that's pretty evident how that went around.
Just enough to lift up the rear tires, and the fact that Hathaway stopped put him down a lap, and there's Dumoulin down pit lane. Now here comes Hathaway back into pit lane. This time he'll stop. Todd?
Lots of front end damage to that 3 of Jason Hathaway. The crew over the wall to clear the fiberglass away. They're going to check on that radiator as well and tie up those loose brake hoses. The 59 of Gary Clute also making a stop. Fuel this time only.
And we can tell you the rain has started to come down. There you see it on the front window of the Can-Am number 32 of LeBay, and you see it in the lights all the way around this racetrack.
And the rain is coming down fairly heavily. That's a problem for these Goodyear Racing slicks. No treads on these. You're watching NASCAR on TSN.
Well, we're briefly under a red flag here at Saint-Eustache, a passing rain shower. It's gone. Teams like the 27 of Andrew Ranger taking advantage, though. Tires for them, the 18 and the 3. Some other cars stopped. Jason Hathaway got out of his car and had some words with Alex Tagliani during that red flag, though.
The 3 driver is not happy with the contact in turn 4 that brought out the caution. Todd was right in the thick of things, and Hathaway was right up in the kitchen at Tagliani. You can hear them explaining, and it almost doesn't matter what they're saying. When it comes to race car drivers and accidents, this has been brewing for quite some time, Dave. They're trying to say their piece.
You had a little chat with Alex Tagliani. You two have been involved, it looks like, from the beginning. What did you say?
Yeah, I mean, it's been going on all year. He's trying to tell me he didn't mean to do it, but, you know, whatever. It's Saint-Eustache. That's the way it goes. If you want to pay somebody back, it's a good night to do it. So hopefully we get this thing going, get green flag again. We'll see what happens.
Seems pretty ominous there. We'll keep an eye on the 3 and the 18 as we get back under green. We're working lap 85. John Gibbs with a green flag in hand. He lets them loose as Alex LeBay will lead him into turn number 1.
These front runners stayed on the racetrack, Dave. They're on fresh tires. They want to get to the halfway point, and a great start for Alex LeBay.
Should mention, too, during that caution period, the number 25 of Smoltz-Ovien received the free pass. And here you can see it's still tight at the front of the field. Look at two old foes in Mark Dilley and DJ Kennington battling side by side.
Reminiscent of a lot of races we've seen over the years. But I can't say enough for the 74 of Kevin Lacroix. Bumper to bumper has a huge cheering section here for him tonight, and he's not letting them down.
On board LP Dumoulin, as you see the battle just ahead for fourth spot between Cayden Lapcevich and the 17 of DJ Kennington. The outside really not the place you want to be, and Kennington knows that. Look at how quickly he drops down behind your points leader.
You want to battle for position here, Dave, but when your spotter says, hey, you can get in behind this car if you just let them go. Sometimes you hang up on the outside for too long, you wind up losing 4 spots instead of 1.
Those who stop for tires, though, during that caution period will feel like Superman at this point. They can carve their way through the field with brand-new Goodyear Eagles. However, we are playing the rain game. There's a lot of people watching the skies. We mentioned earlier, now we're seeing some lightning pop up in places.
It's been significant here tonight, Dave, and the drivers have to be able to see it. The lightning is all sort of off the front straightaway, so as they go down through 3 and 4, all the pit crews can see it, the drivers can see it. There's a sense of urgency to this race.
Good nose-to-tail battle there for fourth spot on back. Cayden Lapcevich in the 76 does have fourth, and there's a good look at the 47 of LP Dumoulin. Now, he's in ninth. The three is in 13th, one lap down, Lapscar Hathaway, and the one is in 14th, also one lap down.
More importantly to our storyline, Alex Tagliani has three cars between himself and the three.
That's important for that payback that we heard about from Jason Hathaway in the pits, and problems once again for Simon Zielvien in the 95 of Anthony Simone.
Simone getting another bit of a run at the 25 of Dion Vienna, or else he grabbed the wrong gear.
Leader comes in under caution. It's fuel this time by the 74, also along pit road. He's taking tires. Will they return for another stop? Little boxed in for the 32. Alex LeBay backs out. He heads out. He'll beat the 74. DJ Kennington also along pit road for a long fuel stop.
Matad, not everybody down pit lane, so this will hand the lead to the 02 of Mark Dilley. Cayden Lapcevich now up to second. Restart number three here at the Lucas Oil 250 at Autodrome Saint-Eustache.
Ready. Great.
It's the 11th event of the 12th race schedule for the NASCAR Pinty Series. I'm Dave Bradley along with Adam Ross. Todd Lewis is trackside. Sean Gibbs once again sending the field back to green, and we've got a side-by-side battle at the front.
Wow, Alex Tagliani wasted no time going to the bottom. That hung Cayden Lapcevich way up on the outside, but it sure paid off for Tags.
Mark Dilley's going to drop in behind in the Johnsonville 0-2, so we're single file through the top three. You see Andrew Ranger up on the outside trying to hang on.
Remember the 18 of Tagliani just after that red flag, basically right around that time. He put on his new right side tire, so he's made his stops for the night.
So a little bit of damage to the number 59 CTL Financial Dodge of Gary Klute from earlier contact. He has some tape up over the hood. You see the black spot on the hood of that car, but it doesn't seem to be affecting him too badly sitting inside the top five.
Andrew Ranger hard on the throttle, trying to get a run on the 59. He'll go to the inside once again.
You can see those bumps coming off of turn number two, and the car's way down on the inside. The back end starts to hop. More contact from Laquan Dumoulin.
He's learning how to short track race, and this is the way to do it. Okay, I can hit him that hard. It doesn't move him enough, but it gave me a hole. I'll drive down and make it work.
Remember, Laquan's first start on an oval was at Kawartha Speedway 1 year ago, and he seems to have learned a lot since then.
The difference between Kawartha Speedway and Saint-Eustache is kind of like the difference between CFL football and the Arena League.
On board Alex LeBay in the Can-Am Ford Fusion.
Look at him roll into that corner. Alex LeBay really settles the car down, closed in on the back bumper of Kennington.
Seems to be the trick here. You don't have a long straightaway to be able to use a lot of horsepower, but if you can roll that car through the center of the corner, you're going to pick up lap time.
Steve Simmons is yours. We've got a side-by-side battle for the lead. Oh, and Tags is going to slide back a long way.
You can see them all lining up behind the 76 of Lapcevich. Contact from the 76 on the 18, and look at Tagliani able to thread the needle and jump down to the inside.
If Tagliani hadn't gotten physical right then, he would have slid back almost out of the top 10.
We hit the halfway mark here in the Lucas Oil 250 at Autodrome Saint-Eustache. Mark Dilley slides up just a little bit, and Cayden Lapcevich takes a look.
Hear how long it took them to finally get on the throttle? We'll be back with more of the Lucas Oil 250.
Mark Dilley from Barrie, Ontario in the 02 Mixed Motorsports Leland Johnsonville Ford leads the Lucas Oil 250, but he has company.
Kevin Laquan, that bumper-to-bumper number 74. Man, he's been fast tonight. That car just looks so comfortable to drive.
But how about Mark Dilley? This far up in the field, he has had a really frustrating at times 2016 season. He needs another good finish.
It really has been frustrating for that entire group, and they're racing with heavy hearts this weekend as well. SpongeBob, Bob DeWolf, lost his mother recently. Great to see him here at the racetrack. This is where he's the happiest, so he needs something to smile about, that's for sure.
Yeah, it'd be great to win one for him for sure, but Dilley struggling right now up in that high groove. Now he finally gets back down to the inside, tucks in behind the Kappa Can-Am Ford of Alex LeVay.
On board with Cayden Lapcevich, having a look to the inside. Dave, does it feel to you like Lapcevich is kind of taking it easy tonight? He hasn't forced too much.
Yeah, he seems to be holding back just a little bit, and you can hear it from those onboard shots that he's feathering the gas. But you don't think that racing is emotional. This team, the 02 team, looking for a strong finish, and that's team owner Kerry Mix.
Well, to get technical, Kerry's boss, Susan Mix, is the team owner, but the figurehead is Kerry Mix.
Kerry prepares those race cars. Mark Dilley doing a good job driving. We got a battle for top spot. The 17 of Kennington goes to the inside of the 74 of Kevin Lacroix.
And Alex LeVay has picked it up a notch. He wants to get in on the battle as well. Kennington working the inside groove. Kevin Lacroix giving him lots of room on the bottom, trying to keep his momentum on the high side.
It's a great thing about Saint-Eustache. Every time you turn around, you turn back to the racetrack and you've got a battle for the lead.
You know, there's always action somewhere. This racetrack, you can watch one car drive alone on this racetrack, and it's dynamic.
LeVay's going to take away second spot as Kevin Lacroix does have a gap in behind the 32, so he'll drop back down to the inside.
The top three still nose to tail, and here's the battle for fourth. Cayden Lapcevich still on the tires he started the race with, makes a pass on Mark Dilley.
Riding on board to take a look out the back bumper of the 76, Dodge Challenger of Cayden Lapcevich. And you can see the 02 a little bit out of shape off of turn number two.
The track getting a little bit slick for these drivers. We're a long way into this race. Everything is overheated, including the drivers themselves, as Alex Tagliani looking to break into the top five.
And there you see the 02 Leland Ford Fusion of Mark Dilley gets a little bit crossways, and this back up at the front once again. Here we go, another battle for the lead. The 17 of Kennington has it, the 32 of LeVay wants it.
And another great battle is Jason Hathaway, who's gotten back on the lead lap. He's racing for the fourth position with Lacroix.
Beat up front bumper, third spot for the 74 of Kevin Lacroix. A beat up front bumper on the three, but he's making it work as Hathaway, very quick on the inside, and he give him that spot.
So Jason Hathaway, he is motivated, a little bit of anger inside the helmet. It's working for him, whatever it is, Dave.
Well, he doesn't have a win yet in 2016, looking to break through to victory lane for the first time this season here at Autodrome Saint-Eustache.
DJ Kennington has company still with the 32 of Alex LeVay. LeVay just ever so smoothly running that inside groove about 2 feet lower than Kennington. Not enough room to make a move just yet, but as I say that, pokes to the inside on the backstretch.
LeVay able to pinch that car down hard off the turns. We'll see if he does it again off turn number four. He gets there, but can't quite get the run as the front end steps out. And we've got caution on the track once again.
We've got a few cars mixed up in turn number three. Simone Dion-Vienne in the 25, he'll come directly to pit road.
And the 74 of Kevin Lacroix also involved, right on board the three.
Wow, Jason Hathaway, who just got back on the lead lap. We're into the top three, rather. Close quarters racing, you see, locked up the brakes, but got into the 25. Oh, and that's Kevin Lacroix, got a big piece of the accident.
Lacroix's in for work, Todd.
Oh, that car is all askew as he makes his way along pit road. Yeah, there's body damage, the left front tire is down, but there may be more damage underneath that 74. Such a strong runner a little while ago, but now Kevin Lacroix along pit road.
We can see Don Thompson Jr. on top of the pit box pointing and shouting instructions. Remember, not all the crew speaks English like Donnie does, so communication can be hard.
DJ Kennington leads under caution here on the Lucas Oil 250. DJ Kennington and his number 17 Castrol-Edge Dodge has the inside line while Alex LeBay is on the outside for this restart here on lap 176 at Autodrome Saint-Eustache. You can hear the revs pick up off turn number 4, and the green flag flies once again.
DJ Kennington with the preferred inside groove, but if anyone can make the high line work, Alex LeBay. And wow, Simone Diofien came out right in front of the race leaders.
He's trying to stay to the inside as much as possible to keep out of their way, and he's doing a pretty good job, but it's difficult here on such a tight track, and the field bunches up behind.
He's trying to get seat time. It's his first ever oval race. His spotter would have done him a favor there, Dave, to say don't come out of the pits until the field goes by.
Taking a look back at the 3 of Jason Hathaway. That's from your race leader, the 17 of DJ Kennington, as he's now opening up a gap on that battle for second. The fender flapping on the Ray Vestas Chevrolet.
And one thing I can't believe, the 76 didn't pit for tires under that last yellow. We're getting down to the late stages of this race.
Yeah, he'll be needing those very, very shortly, as Cayden Lapcevich still very comfortably inside the top 5.
Yeah, guys, we were surprised that the 76 didn't make a stop either, but here's the reason why. They're watching their weather, and they believe that rain is imminent. They're staying out, holding on to their track position. Others have fresh tires. Is he vulnerable, or is it the right strategy call? We're going to find out.
Well, just in behind this battle here is a 0-2 of Mark Dilley in the Leland Ford Fusion. He did stop during that last caution, but picked up fuel only.
And I get the strategy they were running by staying on the racetrack, but that ship has sailed. We passed halfway, the rain didn't come, and there's not that many cars behind them still on the lead lap. It's time to take rubber.
And it's time to go if you're the 0-2 of Mark Dilley, aggressively looking to the inside of the 76 of Lapcevich. Battle for fifth spot.
Dilley with a good run through the middle of 3. Just a little nudge of Lapcevich, trying to move him up the racetrack just like this to get the preferred line in 1 and 2.
But you see how much two cars battling side by side slows them down on this racetrack. Alex LeBay able to work his way out to about a 5-car length lead over that battle.
And this track more so than a lot of racetracks. As we said, the difficult nature, the flat racetrack. The next race we have at Kawartha Speedway, you can run side by side and not lose a whole lot of speed. You can't do that here at Saint-Eustache.
While we watch this battle a little deeper in the field, inside the top 5, the 17 of DJ Kennington has a healthy lead. You saw his roof flash by there over the 3 of Jason Hathaway. So Kennington almost on cruise control here out front.
We spoke earlier about the problems with the front bumper. Aerodynamics a non-issue as Alex LeBay races on the inside of Mark Dilley. But Alex Tagliani would love to nudge the 3-car out of the way, but he doesn't have much front bumper left to do it with, and he's already made him angry enough earlier in the race.
Then they almost made contact. They may have made contact there a couple times. He saw the 3 get a little crossways, but LeBay was pedaling as he tucks in behind the 18 of Alex Tagliani.
This is unbelievable. Mark Dilley in the 0-2. We have not seen anybody make progress on the outside, but Dilley is looking to pass Tags in the high groove.
Tagliani driving it off the right rear down the front straightaway.
And he just really pinched off Dilley towards the wall. That doesn't slow Dilley down. He's still going to the outside.
On board LeBay as he works the inside lane. Little contact there with Mark Dilley.
This is unbelievable driving skill as LP almost turns to the pit road exit to get under the 32 of LeBay.
Well, he forced his way in there in the WeatherTech Dodge. And now Tagliani with Dilley up on the outside. How is he making that outside groove work?
Mark Dilley is on a mission. Tagliani closed the door on him about 4 times, and he never gave up as LP looking to the inside. Give Mark Dilley the position.
Almost 3 wide there as LP Dumoulin stuck his nose in. But Mark Dilley goes to third spot. Tagliani in fourth. Now LP Dumoulin holding on to the fifth spot. And Cayden Lapcevich hanging back there saying, whoa, this is getting a little bit too serious for me.
What a mishmash of race cars. Hathaway's car has been through hell and back. Mark Dilley barely a mark on the 0-2. You can see they're running real similar speeds, but that's the kind of racing you get here.
Battle for second, and it won't be much of a battle as Dilley able to go through relatively unscathed. Now, you remember 1 year ago, the 0-2 stepped on the podium. Mark Dilley coming home second in this race last year.
And look at how quickly he pulls away from the three of Hathaway. DJ Kennington better have one eye on that rearview mirror.
But look at that gap right there. That's the difference between first and second as Mark Dilley works his way through lap traffic and gets around the number 25 of Simon Zielbien.
I'm curious to see. Dilley is a little bit faster right now according to our scoring monitors. It's a long way to get to DJ Kennington, and it's one thing to catch him. It's another thing entirely to pass him in the last 50 laps of the race.
He is closing, though. Look at how tight it is now between the top two. And this is a battle for third spot with Hathaway and Dumoulin.
LP Dumoulin's got a lot of race car left as we ride on board with the WeatherTech number 47.
Jason Hathaway just ahead. The 74 of Kevin Lacroix back on track. He's a couple laps down, and Hathaway, there you saw Fender fall off the three of Hathaway.
Directly into the path of the 47, and indeed, right in front of the air intake for the engine. This could be a problem for Dumoulin.
Piece of fiberglass hanging onto the nose of that race car, and here's the problem. As he stays at speed, the air is going to press that piece of fiberglass right against the nose of the WeatherTech Dodge and keep it there.
He needs to catch Hathaway and hit him.
He probably wants to at this point.
That'll knock the fiberglass off the front as each of them go to the inside of Gary Klute.
Battle for ninth spot now. The 27 of Andrew Ranger and the 9 of Adam Martin. Martin looking to run a full season in the Johnsonville Ford Fusion next year, so just getting that all-important seat time, and look what's gone.
I don't know where it went.
Well, I do. It's on the racetrack because the caution flag is flying. So debris reported in turn number one. So the NASCAR officials will head out and clean that up. It is the fender of the three car of Jason Hathaway, or at least a small piece of it.
Up in the outside groove where it could pose a bit of a problem. So they'll send the safety crew out to pick that up. And let's have another look here. There's LP Dumoulin. You can see the piece there.
Now you see it? Now you don't.
He got close enough to the three car that the air knocked it off.
You see down pit lane, the 76 of Lapcevich is in. Dot.
The yellow flies in the 76 can make his pit stop for tires. Fresh right side rubbers for rookie Cayden Lapcevich going on. How far back in the field will he be? Will there be enough laps for him to charge back forward? He will have the freshest tires. Going to be fun to watch.
Sluggish stop for the 76 of Lapcevich, but DJ Kennington is in control of the Lucas Oil 250.
Words we love hearing as the field gets back underway. DJ Kennington and Mark Dilley side by side through one and two.
Man, how many times have we seen this front row in a row?
Look at this!
Wow, they're bouncing off each other in the back straightaway. Hathaway in the three, Dilley in the 0-2, they're still not finished.
Hathaway in what amounts to an open wheel modified at this point. You see the fender still flapping off the right-hand side of the Ray Bestis Chevy.
It is chaos on this restart. DJ Kennington pulling away.
And Dumoulin made contact with the three, and it looks like a tire down.
No, the rear end is out of that race car,
Dave. Yeah, you're right. You can see the sparks. I thought something had gone wrong in the front end, but it's actually in the back end of the WeatherTech Dodge.
Track bar trailing arm on that race car. Something is broken there. That's what locates the rear end. You can see whichever way the car's going, the rear axle shifting to the left and the right.
And there you can tell something is going horribly wrong. But we stay under green as Dumoulin has found pit lane. No caution yet. DJ Kennington still out in front. LeBay sneaks by the three.
Wow, Cayden Lapcevich. Little bit of contact with the 18 of Tagliani. Tags was trying to get to the inside. Here we are with LP.
And you can see the crew, not a lot of action there. They're telling that the problem is in the rear. They're up on the jacks, and they'll have to put it up on the jack stands and do some really serious fixing work on that Dodge.
That's not a problem you fix at the racetrack. They're done for the night for sure.
How about the number 27 of Andrew Ranger? The Mopar Dodge has been counted out several times this season, but here he is sitting in third spot at Autodrome Saint-Eustache, a place he's won in the past.
And as the laps start to wind down, here's Cayden Lapcevich passing race cars. He really couldn't pass all night long, but he's got fresh rubber on the right side, and it's really serving him well.
And you can look, just look ahead a bit. Just down the racetrack, you see a battle for the lead with DJ Kennington and Mark Dilley nose to tail.
Dilley looking to the inside of Kennington through three and four. We can see through the windshield there as Cayden Lapcevich looks for room to work on Andrew Ranger.
Inside. Still there, quarter. Still there, inside.
Car works just so good on the inside for Cayden Lapcevich. He sticks it on that white line, little crossways from the 27 of Andrew Ranger, and that's all it's going to take. Give Cayden Lapcevich the position. And we got problems.
Ranger goes around Alex LeMay trying to fill the hole that Cayden Lapcevich made, and Ranger did not lift. Goes around, grabs a gear.
He lit up the rear tires of the Mopar Dodge and got going. Caution flag flies, though, so that'll slow the field and bunch him back up. We'll have another restart when we return. St. Thomas, Ontario's DJ Kennington has not visited Victory Lane since August of 2014. And the two-time NASCAR champion looking for it tonight with just 19 laps to go.
And Mark Dilley, it's been even longer. It was 2011 when he last won.
Well, as history shows us, if you're DJ Kennington, you're feeling pretty good about this because a Dodge has won every single NASCAR Pinty Series stop here at Autodrome Saint-Eustache.
That's a pretty impressive statistic. But don't tell that to Cayden Lapcevich, who also drives a Dodge.
Mark Dilley drops into third in front of the flailing number three of Hathaway that's still inside the top five. Almost miraculously, he's having a great run in that beat-up race car. But now, Tagliani joins him in the top five.
And Cayden Lapcevich all the way up alongside the 17 on the inside.
There'll be 16 laps to go, this time across the stripe. DJ Kennington leading Cayden Lapcevich. You remember when DJ Kennington used to be called the Castro Kid? Well, it's a new kid in town. The 76 of Lapcevich goes to the inside. They make contact.
Wow, Lapcevich got into Kennington, up over the rumble strips, into Kennington again, and they both gathered it in.
Fitting place for a drag race down the drag strip here at Autodrome Saint-Eustache. They turn left into turn one, still banging fenders.
This is short track racing at its finest, and look at Mark Dilley closing.
And Dilley trying to get his nose in. He actually made contact with the 17 of Kennington, but Kennington able to fall into line.
They're single file for the time being, but there's another storm brewing here at Saint-Eustache.
Just in behind is a tightly knit pack of race cars as they all chase the 76 of Cayden Lapcevich.
Look at the Johnsonville number 9 of Adam Martin. Right at the tail end of this pack of leaders, this is as fast as he's been all night long.
Got some new tires, and that car is working very well as he goes underneath the Can-Am Ford Fusion. And problems! Big wreck going into turn number 3. Tagliani and Hathaway, where have we seen this before?
Well, you knew that was going to happen in the closing stages. Let's have another look. Hathaway on the outside, Tag on the inside.
You know what? I don't think that was meant for a spin. It just looks like Tagliani got loose.
It was a racing deal, but when you touch tires like that, well, now Tag really got loose.
And that one, wow, might have not been a racing deal. These two have been at it all season long. You heard Hathaway earlier on in the show. Let's take a look at what started this all. This is in Saskatoon.
Part of the Western swing. Hathaway goes three wide, up into Tagliani. Tag didn't like it. Fast forward to earlier on tonight.
This was during a rain delay. Hathaway got out of the car, actually had words with Tagliani, but back under green now, a green-white checker to settle it. Lapcevich first to the inside, and now LeBay goes around in turn number one.
Dilley up into LeBay, or LeBay down into Dilley. Either way, Alex LeBay in turn number two, standing still, but there is no yellow.
Staying under green, the top three all single file at the front, and Cayden Lapcevich will be the first to the white flag. Ontario.
Lapcevich pulling away. Adam Martin looking to the inside of Dilley for third, but the 16-year-old Cayden Lapcevich is going to win race number three.
and high fives all around in a Lapcevich pit. Kennington will come home second, but when we return, we'll talk to the winner in victory lane.
The smile is clearly visible again on his face and that of that whole 76 team. Cayden Lapcevich secures his third victory of the season. Congratulations from Jeff. It was seemed like a strange call to have you stay out for those fresh tires, but it may have worked to your advantage at the end.
Well, we had a weather guy down in the pits for us. He's like, storm's coming. And, he said that for 100 laps. And finally, when we got the caution with 50 to go, so I'm like, I made the call. I'm like, we're coming for tires. We're doing this. So, I think it was okay of a call to wait for tires so long. We were really good in the short run. I couldn't do those 100 lap strengths, but, it ended up all right for us.
Cayden Lapcevich, victory number three. Guys, a storm is coming.
Hey, buddy.
What a race. What an unlikely charge to the front for Cayden Lapcevich, who restarted 10th. Here's your results.
And you can see Adam Martin, a solid top five finish in fourth. Larry Jackson in sixth spot. Andrew Ranger all the way down in eighth. And LeBay came back for ninth. Todd's with your second place finisher.
DJ Kennington led a whole bunch of laps, but I think it was the fresher tires that ended up costing you at the end. But boy, what a strong car you had.
Awesome car. Castrol Edge Dodge was awesome tonight. Really nice to have a rebound. We've been struggling lately, and I hate it for my sponsors, my team, Brian Cathcart, Mopar, Canadian Linen, everybody that helps us out. We really appreciate all your support and sticking with us, and Just Reps, everybody that does stuff for us. You can't remember them all when it's important, but my family, sticking with me, my race team, man, we'll get there. We'll be back in victory lane real soon, but hopefully next week at Kawartha.
And we'll take a look at the points and a stretched points lead now for Cayden Lapcevich over Andrew Ranger, 41 markers.
The battle for third is still the exciting battle. Lacroix in the 74, Tagliani, LP Dumoulin. Good points day for Larry Jackson, still in the top 10.
So the podium celebration has begun, and the man standing on the top step is the 76 of Cayden Lapcevich, and a little friendly bump there from DJ Kennington. The Lucas Oil 250 has been brought to you by Pinty's, making great food fun, and by Honeygoo from CleanFlow, one honey of a lube.
Should be a wild show next weekend. Cayden Lapcevich needs to take the green flag to make NASCAR history.
The Kawartha 250 at Kawartha Speedway from all of us here at Fuel Media Lab. See you there.
This copyrighted telecast may not be reproduced, retransmitted, or used in any form without the authorized written consent of NASCAR Broadcasting. NASCAR would like to thank all of our loyal fans for your continued support, and we hope you enjoyed today's broadcast.